curtain set in the West for pro football's greatest running back, it rose in the East for other runners who were both excellent and ambitious. In Buffalo, the Bills found that the sum of its parts were equal to the whole left by O.J.'s absence. Delvin Williams, number 24, the man Simpson replaced in San Francisco, gained almost 1,300 yards for the Miami Dolphins. Quarterback Archie Manning, number 8, led the New Orleans Saints to the best record in their history and was voted the NFC Player of the Year. While Manning earned his fame through a season's play, others gained glory in a single game. In the season's third week, on a dreary Monday night in New England, running back Joe Washington, number 27, led a Baltimore Colt team to victory over the powerful Patriots. Washington's heroics helped tie the game at 24, and with less than 2 minutes to play, this man who threw for one touchdown and caught another brought new meaning to the term triple threat.
Here's a line knuckleball bouncing downfield. Washington, I think, at the Baltimore 10 to the 15. Upfield, still on his feet, out of the open momentarily, and he's going to be caught. No, he is. He's on his feet.
Go, go.
Washington is going down into New England territory.
He's going to go.
He's going to score.
Oh, my.
Joe Washington returns 91 yards.
Oh, my.
Go to war, Miss Agnes.
Did we find a guy when we got this guy?
Joe Washington. Joe, how'd you like to be mayor?
One thing remained unchanged in this season of contrast. The Dallas Cowboys ruled the National Football Conference. No team challenges you with so many great athletes, but camouflaged beneath all their flashy feints and jabs is a heavyweight right hand under the heart. The Cowboys' only roadblock to Super Bowl XIII were the confident Los Angeles Rams.
We want Dallas!
Dominant on defense, opportunistic on offense, Dallas shut out the Rams and won a convincing 28-0 victory. Like the Cowboys, there was another team who thought there was only one thing to be in the NFL, and that was champion of it. Quarterback Terry Bradshaw, the Pittsburgh Steelers, started out as a rookie who was carried by a great team and has developed into a veteran who now carries the team. Bradshaw and receiver Len Swan, number 88, may be pro football's most dynamic combination, but the Steelers' strength derives from a variety of sources. Some teams are known for their defense, for speed and hustle. Some for their offense, and a few like the Pittsburgh Steelers, for all of these qualities. With the best record in the NFL, the Steelers swept into the AFC Championship game.
So the Steelers go in with plenty of offense and lots of defense, and it takes us back to those 74 and 75 teams. Plus, which the Steelers have that terrible cow going for them. Yep, this year we've had a revival of the terrible cow. And this carried the Steelers all the way in 75. It imputes great strengths to the Steelers, and if need be, poses mysterious difficulties for the enemy. You'll see thousands upon thousands of terrible towels waving out in those stands today. The terrible towel is poised to strike. So are the Steelers.
The Cinderella Houston Oilers proved no match for the mighty men of the Pittsburgh Steelers, and they were crushed 34-5. Steelers are the ultimate combination of the professional and the amateur, a word that traces to the Latin amator and suggests one who brings a passion to what he does.
The real love for the game, I realize how important it is and how much it means to me to play. I really love it. This is my ninth year and I still love it. I enjoy what I'm doing and running with the football or throwing it or whatever. It's fun.
Some play pro football for fun, others for fame, and still others for money. For 17 seasons, one man has played for all of these reasons. Fran Tarkenton has earned every meaningful honor, holds every important record at his position, and has won every game but the Super Bowl. Every year, the experts predicted his finish. But he has made a career proving them wrong from the start. In possibly his last season, he has again stirred the statisticians, enthralled the fans, and enliven the game. For the young, there will be a next year. But for many, the future may never be as glorious as their past. The mighty men of 1978. Some old, some young. Some have won, some have lost. But all have shared the magic moments of a great year.
On Sports World, competition for you on a future Sports World show. Right now, let's go down to the field.